got four rappies inside my DNA. I got power, poison, pain, and joy inside my DNA. I got hustle, no ambition, flow inside my DNA. I was born like this,
what's up, guys?
Immaculate conception, I transform like this, perform like this. Was y'all, she one new weapon, I don't contemplate. I meditate, then off your fucking head. This that puts the kids to bed.
Patrick, waiting on you, brother. What's up, Sonny Money Mayo in the building? What's up, Shelly?
You here, man? We do this every fucking time.
There we go. That's my thought.
There he is. How you doing, champ?
Doing good, bud. Doing good. How are you?
I'm good. Happy anniversary, man. I didn't mean to pull you away from your proceedings. I'll let you get back here in just a minute.
No, that's fine. It's fine. We're waiting on our daughter to get home from swim practice.
Ah, nice.
So, your girls are
quite the proficient swimmers in the old militant home.
Swimmers and rowers.
Oh, is that what you got going on now?
Yeah, my oldest daughter is a rower, getting offers from D1 schools. And so it's good, man. It's good.
Well, I expect nothing less from
hardworking kids, man. Hardworking kids.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So tell everybody who we're, well, scheduled to have on tomorrow. We were supposed to have him on.
Yeah, we were supposed to have him last week. Tomorrow, Dr. Jerome Corsi, he author, scholar. He was a part of the Mueller investigation. We're going to have him on at noon tomorrow. It won't be live, but then I will probably post it around 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock. But yeah, that should be fun, man. Dr. Jerome Corsi,
His part in the Mueller investigation was, well, he was one of the people being investigated. And not only did Mueller threaten him, by Dr. Corsi's account, but tried to frame him. And now Dr. Corsi was not indicted and is now suing Mueller and the DOJ, if I'm not correct.
Yeah,
or
he's
not
suing
Mueller. I should say.
No, yeah, you're absolutely correct. He is suing Mueller.
He's a big name.
He is a big name. He's a big name, and a lot of people, you know, question his veracity, you know, who's he, you know, like anybody else, you know, according to the internet world, I'm a shill. I work for the government. Pat's a shill. He works for the government. So, you know, we're going to get him on. He's, you know, obviously had his flack about who he actually is beholden to, but like Pat said, he's a big name, and he has an interesting story, dude, because some really shady shit went down in the Mueller investigation. We're going to get into Michael Cohen and all of that good stuff, but in particular, this video, I wanted it to address some of the more recent stuff we have going on and some information that I've come across that I've just feeding into my brain. And I had to do a live tonight. Pat said it was his anniversary. I'm like, I need you, champ, because I can't just keep this crap in my brain. I would have rolled solo if I had to, but I always love rolling with the champ. So,
well, and if you and I both end up dead tomorrow, it's not because of the deep state. It's because of my wife, and it's my anniversary.
Lynn Militant has her own.
Sonny Bozikas joining us.
What's up, Sonny? I'm sure Lynn has her own fleet of drones that she will send down here to St. Louis and just take my little high yellow ass out for fucking with her anniversary. But no, for real though, you know, we've been talking about it for months and years, whatever. Who runs the world? Smedley Butler said it, you know, many, many years ago that war is a racket. And, you know, we're seeing it play out, man. John Bolton has been fired. We saw that. But like I said, and I had read, you know, a couple other places, his job was over. He planted the seeds for more war to be popping off in these particular regions. We have Venezuela still going on, and obviously we have what's going on in Iran. We have the Saudi oil field hit, you know, whatever that was 2 or 3 days ago.
Yeah, the refineries.
the refineries. So, and you know, and they're tripping over their story already. There's evidence it came from Iran. There's evidence it came from Iraq. There's evidence they're saying it's Houthi rebels. This is all just Gulf of Tonkin bullshit, ladies and gentlemen. However you want to slice it, this is just another way for them to get us into another war, period, the end. We can argue about the means to which they do it and how they go about it, but General Wesley Clark said this not too long after 2001. The list of countries that were on, whatever you want to call them, the globalists' lists, and Iran was one of them. Hezbollah and what's going on in Lebanon was one of them. None of this is by accident right now. So pay attention to that, obviously.
You know what I will say? I will give NBC credit for this.
Oh, my goodness.
I'm just going to do it. But this morning, you know, when they reported on the attacks on the Saudi Arabian refineries, you know, they said that Trump's top spokesman said that it was Iran, but offered no proof. And I went, you know what? They're finally starting to catch on. Maybe it's a slow bleed. I don't know. But look, we still haven't
because
had
they know we're catching
up. Iran.
Yeah.
So that's
they know through shows like ours and other great shows, people are just catching on. It's not just our shows. People are just getting more educated to the work. People are understanding that things, you know, they're tired of being fed sewer rat and told it's pumpkin pie. And we're just starting to get it. And the Epstein thing, like we've talked about before, that was such a massive red pill for a lot of people. Like, all right, I may not go as far as Pat and everybody else goes, but something's up with this.
Why do you blame me? Why would you say Pat? Why don't you say Jeff?
No, I said Pat or me. I don't go as deep as what Pat or Jeff says.
I'm teasing.
But at the end of the day, this is what we're left with now. We're left with Epstein dead. The case has been dropped. And what we're about to get into here in a minute, I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, this shit is nothing short of mind-blowing. The depth of what Epstein was into and this whole network. It's a global network of everything
we talked about. I think we should delve right into the intelligence and modern monitoring systems that we're talking about. You know,
we're going to end with that, but that's what people need to understand. Okay. The news is saying Epstein has been involved in child trafficking and human trafficking, which he has been. But as Pat and I have talked about many times on this show, this global black market economy that runs the freaking world, oftentimes, it's people, it's people's body parts, it's drugs, it's guns, and other things. And then it's finding these financial institutions to wash the hundreds of billions of dollars from these proceeds. And that's exactly what Jeffrey Epstein was involved in. Kids was just
let's talk about
part
that
of
bank.
It.
Let's talk about HSBC.
HSBC is the new bank, but this goes back to BCCI, the Bank of Commercial Credit International, where you have so many players involved in this, from Khashoggi helping with Iran-Contra. I mean, there's just so much to this, man. And
well, that's the thing. You know, we can go back to Jamal Khashoggi and supposed journalist as he was painted correctly.
He was a contract agent or he worked for the Mossad as well as the CIA.
And his father, Saudi intelligence.
And his father. That's what I'm saying. This goes back decades. So much of this is so
and the Qataris started to pay him off. And
the tangled
he,
web.
He started putting out disinformation about the Saudis with Qatari money. And what's interesting is and I'm not planning on going back there, obviously, when I say this. I didn't plan on going back there when I left. But I can tell you that, I was sitting in the palace in Qatar looking at Saudi military ships offshore that had the embargo on the Qataris. And, the leader of that nation is talking to me and saying, you see the ships offshore here. And it was a very interesting conversation, but I can tell you that, I would say this. The person that hooked me up with that man, the leaders of that country, that led to me sitting down in a palace in Qatar overlooking the ocean with the guy's got billions of dollars of automobiles and planes sitting around. We were discussing a contract, a potential contract for me to train a lot of people. I can just tell you that, look, man, people with that kind of money will pay to get things done that they need done. And he needed some disinformation, some misinformation put out there. Khashoggi was working for him, okay? Khashoggi was working for him and ended up getting whacked for it. And anybody that tells you that Jamal Khashoggi was a journalist is full of shit, because he wasn't. He was an agent. And his front was being a journalist, writing stories. He's full of shit.
As are so many journalists. So many journalists. You go back to the Vietnam War, where they had journalists embedded into certain media outfits to help push the story. And now after 9/11, we've seen, you know, it's just festooned with it. Everybody's being paid to carry the narrative. But, I mean, that's almost just scratching the surface, because that's the stuff that keeps us divided, keeps us arguing.
It's very much on the surface.
But what the interesting shit I found out, man, and I've been reading about, which has just been blowing my mind as far as the depth of the Epstein stuff. So Jeffrey Epstein, who really knows where he got started exactly? You start talking about individuals like Leslie Wexner was where he really got started from. Leslie Wexner has been in intel and in operations for decades as it relates to washing all of this money from these proceeds. Specifically, I guess we could just talk about foreign entities spying on the country. So we've heard about the Pollard case back in the day. The Pollard family was sponsored basically by the Israeli Mossad spying on the country. I think the Awan brothers, who we talked about a long time ago, had a very deep embedded program of providing congressmen and women with Blackberries, which had a certain software on it. The Awan brothers were spying on Congress, et cetera, et cetera. But it even goes back further than that. An individual, this goes back, I'd love to start with like the late 80s and the end of the Cold War. An individual developed a certain kind of software. His name was Peter Thiel. He developed a particular software called Palantir. And so this software, you know, he has contracts with all kinds of different government agencies. But within this software were back doors to be able to spy on American people, period, plain and simple. And they started, there was a particular database. What was it? The Main Core. It's called the Main Core. This was around the Iran-Contra Cold War time, where the Main Core was essentially this is before real internet implementation. The Main Core database or the Main Core program went into what they call COG or continuity of government. So if the shit hit the fan and they needed to know who the certain dissidents were in the country, they would go round them up. And so you're talking about millions and millions of people. And so, oh shit, where's my mouse? This article right here, it's from, damn it, I don't have my mouse on me. All right, I'm sorry. This article is from May 2008. The headline is, Government May Have Massive Surveillance Program for Use in National Emergencies, 8 Million Potential Suspects. And the particular the paragraph that stood out to me was this. According to senior government official, there exists a database of Americans who often, for the slightest and most trivial reason, are considered unfriendly and who in the time of panic might be incarcerated. The database can identify and locate perceived enemies of the state almost instantaneously. One knowledgeable source claims that 8 million Americans are now listed in the Main Core database as potential suspects. Again, this is 2008. In the event of a national emergency, these people... I know, but nothing's changed. In the event of a national emergency, these people could be subject to everything from heightened surveillance and tracking to direct questioning and possible even detention. Now, this coincides with the COG, the National Defense Authorization Act.
Exactly,
which Obama signed into office and Trump has not repealed, which allows for the indefinite detention of Americans, possible assassination, no due process, et cetera, et cetera. This is
You don't even get a phone call to mom and dad.
You don't get nothing, dude. You don't get a fucking thing, but a military.
And you think in 2008 it was 8 million. What do you think it's at now? And at what point does somebody who gets in office, when we get another potential Obama, or hey, does Trump take a bad turn in his second term and suddenly start to imprison people, right?
Absolutely. And it doesn't just stop there, because when you start talking about Epstein associates, everyone knows Epstein's girl who helped facilitate getting these underage girls was a chick named Ghislaine Maxwell. Jizz in the face, whatever you want to call her. Jizz Maxwell is her name. Her sister was a woman by the name of Christine Maxwell. She was the head of this company, this software company called Chiliad. In 2004, and these are all people who work for the Israeli government and the Mossad, by the way. That's almost why this is relevant.
Let's make sure that we're not being anti-Israeli. We're not anti.
Yeah,
anti the controlling arm, whether it be the CIA, the Mossad, Saudi intelligence, any of these groups.
We criticize the CIA, it doesn't mean we're anti-American. We criticize the MI6, doesn't mean we're anti-Britain. Just because we're criticizing the apparatus, the intelligence apparatus of Israel, doesn't mean we're anti-Semitic. And if you have to fucking go there to make yourself feel better, go fuck yourself and go find something else to watch.
Exactly.
So, like I was saying, Christine Maxwell, she had a particular company, Chiliad, where they downloaded their software with backdoors in them in the FBI counterterrorism database, the CIA, the NSA. This is in 2004. So they've been – Epstein was a part of almost he was part of a blackmail operation where he was using sex. But they already had redundancy. They had redundancy in the most highest level of databases in who we are, what we're doing, et cetera, et cetera. What Epstein was doing was more blackmailing high-level people to get in positions of this and that so they can have them by the balls. But it doesn't just stop there. What we're talking about as far as – we've talked about 5G – the Internet of Things. When Alex Jones said your dishwasher is listening to you, the fucker wasn't lying, dude. The fucker was not lying. They have smart streetlights where they can start listening to you. And another particular
parking meters, smart parking meters, everything.
All of it. Streetlights the whole nine. And another company called Carbine 911. Mind you, the guy who made the Palantir software, Peter Thiel, he was one of the heads of Trump's transition team. So he was ensconced in this the whole time. And so what I'm starting to find out with all these shootings and all of these databases and the technocracy and 5G and all of this minority report type shit, they are creating essentially a technocracy, which they want to do what they call pre-crime technology. We've all heard about this. Now check this out.
That's the scariest part right there, man.
Check this out. This is what Donald Trump has said. He's a part of these people who have these softwares. He's promoting red flag laws. Now listen, after two recent mass shootings in El Paso, Texas, and Dayton, President Trump said his administration would ask social media companies, these companies I'm talking about, to develop tools that would detect potential mass shooters. While delivering a speech on the recent violence, Trump said we must do a better job of identifying and acting on early warning signs. He suggested social media companies could develop new ways of catching red flags. I am directing the Department of Justice to work in partnership with local, state, and federal agencies, as well as social media companies, to develop tools that can detect mass shooters before they strike. That's a quote. That's not something made up. That's a quote that you can find that he said. So he's promoting this technology that engages in pre-crime. This, again, coincides with the national – it's the erosion of any rights that you think you might have. NDAA's already done that. If you start saying certain fucking wrong buzzwords that a streetlight picks up or your whatever picks up, these laws allow them to come detain you and ask you what the fuck you're doing. This is the same with red flag laws. If I get mad at Pat and I'm like, I could just – oh, and he breaks up. Of course, you're breaking up.
Can you hear me?
You're breaking up.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you now. Are you still broke up?
IT will make all the phone calls to the police.
Yes. Exactly. Right. And that's what Carbine 911 is. And the head of Carbine 911 is former head of Israel, Ehud Barak. Carbine 911 is about, you don't even have to call 911. They'll call them for you if they hear shit around you or whatever it is. They probably can do it now, Bill Kemper. They absolutely can. And China is the beta test for so much of all of this. Facial recognition,
yeah, they're stopping people from getting on airplanes because of whatever it is.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. So the backbone of this infrastructure and this new kind of technology has back doors in it left and right, which allows massive surveillance of U.S. citizens. And this has been going on for decades. And so, to go back to Epstein, he's been a part of this whole thing. So many different players' names I haven't even mentioned about how they're utilizing these certain companies, washing money, and, you know, the kids is a part of it, the arms is a part of it. Like I said, Jamal Khashoggi was a huge part. Oh, the other thing, Maine Corps literally came out around the time of Iran-Contra, and that was headed up by Ali fucking North, one of the guys who was one of the key players in Iran-Contra. And so, yeah, and they're utilizing the same – There's two types of softwares, Promise and the Palantir software. Both of them, the Palantir and the Promise aren't so much about monitoring so much. The other softwares are doing that. What Palantir and Promise does is basically collates all that data and synthesizes all that data and makes it basically mean sense. But it's in the back door of almost all of these different companies, all these different government agencies. And it's all, I mean, again, I don't give a fuck.
Israeli-run companies. If anybody thinks that Facebook and Twitter rose to prominence without the aid of intelligence communities, they're high.
It's all just data collection, man.
It's all data collection, yes.
30 years ago, they would have had to had personal, they would have had whatever they call it, active personal intelligence to go see when you're taking a shit, when you're going to the movie and all that other stuff. Now we just volunteer that information. It just makes their life so much easier. And it just is basically, again, this is all information. Data is the new oil. We already know Google's selling your kids' information. All of this information is being sold, but what they're doing is creating digital profiles.
I'm constantly reminding my children to not post anything controversial ever. Besides, hi, how are you? Great, I'll see you tonight. That's how it goes.
They're diary of the mouth. They can't help themselves because that's their world now. But that's the thing. That's almost been it's the boiling frog thing. Like they just didn't come out of the box monitoring you and making cell phones and all this stuff so ubiquitous. They just slowly made, you know, they're starting to phase out cash. Now you can buy this by their phone or everything is digital now. But I get it. But at the end of the day, man, this is some Judge Dredd scientific technocracy. It's called the Internet of Things, dude. In a few years, when this 5G is in and your washing machine and your dishwasher, your coffee maker is basically, you're giving all of them this information. And soon we will be removed from a cash-based society. And it will be because they beat everybody over the head with this climate control business. It's going to be an energy-based, carbon-based. How much energy do you take to live your life? Okay, you need credits for this. Money's gone at this point. And if people think that's crazy that I'm saying that that's what's going to be, dude, wait, 10, 15 years, it'll be no time at all. People our age will still be able to see it. It's what they call the Internet of Things. Look it up. It's called the Internet of Things.
It's the big lie on every. It's the big lie on everything, if you think about it. Climate change. Climate change is driven by the sun. If you think that our cars are changing the climate of the earth, I don't know what to tell you. When Graham Hancock and many other scientists are telling us we've entered a solar minimum and we're in basically entering a mini ice age, you know, I tend to believe the guys that aren't getting paid the money for the studies going into a raise in oceans and
heat like the piece of shit in California that was paid like $12 million by the pharmaceutical company to push basically mandatory vaccines in California. It's insane. They're all on the take in some way, shape, form, or fashion. But yeah,
you know, that's the thing. Here's the thing. Think about it. I want everybody to think about this. And I sat back and I thought, and I talked to a couple of people and I thought, I don't vape. I don't ever desire to vape. I don't ever desire to smoke a cigarette. But vaping through these secondhand cartridges or whatever it is exactly has killed 4 people and gotten, you know, other people sick with lung problems. Well, about $500 million has been paid out so far this year for vaccine injuries, but vaccines are mandatory in several states while vaping is being outlawed.
Well, that the tobacco industry. Over 500,000 people die a year from smoking or smoking-related illnesses, and alcohol is just as much. But now we're going after vaping off 6 deaths or whatever it is? Like,
right.
That just lets you know.
Climate change, vaping, you know, the gun violence is not caused by guns. If you're going to be so ignorant to blame inanimate objects for the deaths of human beings. We got a long ways to go, man. We got a long ways to go because, you know, we've talked about it numerous times on the amount of children and adults that are on pharmaceutical drugs, psychotropic drugs, that are destroying their minds, and processed foods, which are poisoning the digestive systems of kids and adults alike, which causes physical and mental, major mental issues. It's proven. It's science. You can look it up. You can study it. So it's undeniable. But then we give them drugs, psychotropic drugs, which are molecularly very close to meth, to solve the problem. You really are doing that to children. You're doing that to your child. And I'm not pointing fingers here. You were told that by your doctor.
I am.
You were told that by your teacher.
That Purdue company, that company that makes OxyContin,
they're finally filing bankruptcy.
So they don't have to pay for all the shit they've done. And I heard some of the almost $12 billion that they've made, they've pulled out of the company and put it into their own private trust. This was even before the lawsuit happened and they were getting sued. So, I mean, these guys are all pieces of shit. And I'm telling you, whether it's climate change, a lot of this, ladies and gentlemen, I love everybody, but I don't care if you fucking agree or disagree. This is being run by eugenicists. This goes back. You're talking about your handful of families that think they're better than all of us. And they're poisoning our food, our air, our water, our soil, and starting wars and watching us all fight over it. This is all eugenics, dude. Why the pharmaceutical company is allowed to push this poison? Why the food is allowed to be poisoned the way it is? Why the shit we find in waters is poisoned in our soil? Why these vaccines we know have poison, but they pump our fucking kids with them right as they come out of the womb? This is all eugenics, dude.
What are you talking about? You know how cheap I can get a house in Flint, Michigan right now?
With some nice tasty water too, right?
Brown water, baby. Brown water.
It's the eugenics, man. It's the eugenics. And now it's moving into straight control. It'll get worse before it gets better. They're going to get rid of a shit ton of us because this new technocracy they're bringing in, they're going to be just tagging people left and right. And they don't want to be tagged. What is it? What, we got 7 billion right now? They could do it, but they want to work with less numbers. They want to do some Georgia Guidestone type shit. Take the numbers down significantly and then monitor everyone. And I'm a comic book fan, and I've talked about this all the time. The show Judge Dredd, where there are these mega cities in Chicago or Houston or whatever. And then you have the cursed earth, everything outside of that, where you have people like Pat and myself, self-sufficient, growing their own shit. That's going to be illegal. It's going to be illegal to be self-sufficient. Like, just the same way they're citing people for collecting rainwater, in 10, 15 years, it will be worse. And the thing is, it's going to be different. When you come into the cursed earth with a cell phone, you could be killed immediately. You will be killed immediately. Anything that you have tracking everything, and I'm sure they'll have satellites that are tracking everything too, but any of these things that you bring into these self-sufficient areas, it's going to be a problem, dude, because the schism is going to grow. You're going to have people who, I mean, you see it now. I saw it 10 years ago, people who got into the nightclub first. You know what I mean? I'm first to the nightclub. Go ahead and shit me. You're going to have those idiots sign up for all of this. That's why it's moving into the digital world. All this makes your life. But at the end of the day,
Let's go back, though, and talk about the escalation with Iran. They have tried many false flags. They tried launching a shitty rocket into the green zone into Iraq. They tried pipeline bombing. Then they moved on to oil tankers being bombed with shitty mines above the water line. Then they moved to grabbing oil tankers and holding them hostage, which they've just done again. And now supposedly drone and rocket attacks on Saudi refineries. They're stopping at nothing to make sure that we end up destroying Iran, which is the last remaining nation on the list of Middle Eastern nations and African nations to be destroyed. So what I would say is this, is I've seen a lot of people online defending and actually pushing for, and even Democrats suddenly saying, we need to attack Iran. We can't stand for this. Dude, how hard is it to throw some drones up in the air when you've got the capability and launch a couple missiles and take out a couple refineries and cause some explosions and blame it on Iran and then start a not just a regional war, but potentially a global war, because Iran is a very close ally of Russia and China. I'm telling you, man, I don't know if Trump's tweet about, you know, threatening Iran and saying we've got, you know, a lot of ships and troops in the area, and he's waiting on his experts to give him the word go, or Saudi Arabia even to give him the word go. And I think, to be honest with you, I think he's baiting the globalists with that verbiage to see who comes out of the woodwork and says, let's go after him. Let's do it. Let's get after him. I think he's flushing the people out of the bushes, you know, the pheasants out of the brush, and finding out exactly who's for and against it. And he knows who's on his side and who isn't. Look, if I'm wrong, we're going to end up in a global war. If I'm right, Trump is outsmarting the masses again.
I appreciate your loyalty, brother. I appreciate your loyalty to the dude, but again,
I'm not loyal. I'm saying.
No, I'm just saying. I mean, you're. I know.
I'm at least open-minded enough. Look, I'm open-minded enough to realize that he could potentially not be the white hat, and I'm not okay with that, and I don't think anybody is. And Bill Camper saying, so Iran did none of the seven things you mentioned. Well, it's a good chance, Bill, they didn't. And if they did, it's because – and Bill, here's a wake-up call for you, Bill. So here's a wake-up call for Bill. If Iranian generals and leaders did order those attacks, well, it might have something to do with the pallets and pallets of billions of dollars of American cash that was delivered by the Obama administration directly to the Iranian leaders. Okay? So let's talk real here. All right? People are being paid off to do the shit that they need, because, quite frankly, who needs a war right now? It's not Trump. Trump doesn't need a war. The people that committed severe crimes and treason from the last administration, you know, it's like Andrew McCabe being brought up on charges for, they didn't mention anything even close to treason, which it was, trying to unseat an elected president. Are you kidding me? They called it, misconduct. Are you fucking kidding me? Misconduct, right, for trying to overthrow an elected leader of the United States of America? Dude, wake
up.
That's
what we've seen, dude.
Quit
That's
drinking
why,
Chicago
you know,
water, man.
Well, we saw the Awan brothers, those brothers who had been running a spy ring in Congress, one of the deepest seated, and they got hit with bank fraud. Or, you know, nothing having
they
to do with
the
actual charges.
They had to have talked. They had to have
I disagree. I mean, you could be right. You could be right. But it seems like every time we have these kind of symbolic arrests, it's never like the heavy, like you just said with McCabe, like what? It's his treasonous behavior. It's like prima facie. It's like we all can prove it. But to hit him with these, you know, bogus charges just to make everybody feel better, well, he, you know, he was at least arrested. But again, it's one of those things where I don't trust any of it. It's the
Pakistani nationals can't commit treason against the United States of America. They can commit crimes of war, crimes of, you know,
but they know who brought them in. They know Debbie Wasserman Schultz brought in the Awan, so you could trace it back to them. And this was
she's been
the same time
quiet.
Where
she's been off quiet for a while, hasn't she?
Right.
She's been real quiet.
Bill Camper. Well, you know, she's, you know,
Cheney and Rumsfeld too, Bill. Yeah, absolutely, Bill. Cheney and Rumsfeld are both
all
the same globalist
shitbags. Fucking right, dude. Rumsfeld said the day before.
Quit picking sides, Bill. We're not picking sides. We're just telling you the way it is, man. We're talking about modern times. We're talking about what's going on right now, why we're about to get into a global war.
And to kind of circle back before we dip out, because I don't want to keep Pat too long, the company Carbine 911.
Hold on. He's saying the neocons. The Demicons, the neocons, the global. They're all globalists, so stop it.
It's what do you want to call them, dude? You want to call them Undertaker? You want to call them Shawn Michaels? You want to call them Hulk Hogan?
Right, exactly.
Andre the Giant. Two sides of the same coin. They all work for Vince McMahon. But
they're into bombing brown people and stealing their resources. That's what they're into. That's how they qualify for shitbag in my book.
Yeah, I mean, even what went down in Kosovo and in the Balkans, that wasn't necessarily about brown people. You had Albanians and shit, but that was about, you know, locking down Europe. getting rid of communism and, you know, all that same shit. It's not just like a racial thing. They don't give a fuck where you are. They'll bury you. I mean, look what they did on 9/11, in my humble opinion. That started all this shit. Not started it, but it definitely put it in a high gear. Look at how many freaking Americans they were just willing to kill to fulfill their larger political agenda. And that's the other thing. I mean, I hate to even so close to it, and it's not about being disrespectful to that day and the people who lost their lives. You know, whether it's the Gulf of Tonkin and they killed 58,000 Americans over the course of 10 years, they do not give a fuck about killing us, fellow Americans, to fulfill larger political agendas. And that's how it's been through history. Smedley Butler said that shit, the most highly decorated war veteran, when he died, said he was tired of being a gangster for communism. And he was doing that shit for decades down in South America and Central America, right. And, you know, World War I veteran. I mean, he knew the fucking drill. But they do the same thing. I called into Lee Stranahan this morning, and I'm just like, they were spot-on conversation, but they were talking about Iran and Venezuela. It's the same playbook.
We're going to test. When we have Lee Stranahan on, we're going to at least test him because, you know, he and his co-host laughing at me when I suggested that Epstein was murdered or the Mossad and CIA basically replaced his body and got him out of there, which, look, even Ryan Dawson didn't balk at the idea that that was possible, right? Ryan Dawson does his research. Ryan Dawson's a smart guy.
It's definitely possible.
And he said, you know what? You can't doubt it. You can't say it didn't happen because nobody knows. And those people are powerful enough to do what they want. And look, I get it. He served no purpose after that. Probably murdered, okay? He certainly didn't hang himself. If you're going to hang yourself, Jeff, you're not going to jump off of something and hang yourself and break your own neck. You're going to lay there, drink, I don't know, do whatever you got to do, and just lay there with a rope around your neck until you pass out and asphyxiate or die. But people don't
I'm with you,
tie to the tallest oak tree and jump off the top of their truck to hang themselves. That's not how it generally works. David Carradine hung himself in his shower sitting on a bike.
Yeah, but you know some chick was pissing in his face before he lost consciousness. He was over in Thailand. You know he had some underage fucking Thai chick pissing right in his face. And she's like, oh my God, David Carradine, you don't wake up. You don't wake up. He falls out, dude. People get freaky over there.
I get it.
But again, the mainstream news, they make it. And it's terrible enough, the dark, ritualistic, dark shit they've done with kids. Trafficking them and the abuse they do to them, that is enough to like blow everybody's mind. But when go deep into this rabbit hole, you start talking about the Brothmans, the head of the Seagram's industry, and the Wexners, the head of, you know, it's the depths of the hundreds of billions of dollars they were washing from the proceeds from all this shit, trading in arms and drugs and people. It's fucking mind-boggling. And the shit goes back decades, literally decades. I wonder how this has come out like this. You know what I mean? How we even know about Epstein. I mean, I know they'll throw some Weinsteins over the bus here and there, but Epstein, it goes so far beyond the sex stuff. Again, not that it's not bad enough, but it's
Bill sitting there saying, name the committee who is on the board. Bill, you could probably figure that out on your own, but I can tell you that the globalist organizations such as, you know, the Council on Foreign Relations, the UN, all these different groups. Look, man, there's plenty of powerful people in those organizations who are the Trilateral Commission. We can go down the list, dude. His redundancy
These are all different think tanks that enact the larger agenda, whether it's your Council 300, your Trilateral Commission, et cetera, et cetera. If you know their name, they're not running shit. That's almost the highest level of plausible deniability.
Yeah, to a certain extent.
To a very certain extent. I mean, some of these, again, these eugenics, these families, these bloodlines that are just beyond fucking untouchable. They fund both sides of wars and have throughout history. I mean, this is what I'm talking about. If you know their name, then they're easily compromisable.
So how do we
That's
fix
why
it?
They put them there.
How do we fix it? How do we stop
that's
it?
That's a very – well, you know what, dude?
Is this
and I suggest
– Is our discussion
No,
feudal?
It's not. Absolutely not, dude. I listened to a very interesting conversation. It was a black panel organized by Sean Puffy Combs. You had some hardcore Democrats. You had Killer Mike, who I really fuck with, and I would love to get him on our show. He's a Bernie guy, but he's a smart dude. They had on Candace Owens. And
if he's a Bernie guy,
rapper.
He's not that smart, bro.
No, I get it. But he's Second Amendment like a motherfucker, dude. Like he's a smart right. guy, dude.
Yeah, he is.
Again, you could have smart people who think stupid shit sometimes. But I suggest everybody go check out that panel, dude, because it was a very interesting conversation amongst black
yeah,
folks
it was good.
on what the next step was. And Killer Mike, his main thing was, and I'm fuck with this and I'm with it, you can't fix a broke system. We need some kind of other party. But at the end of the day, you need to, at the most grassroots level, organize. People need to
Where's
be
the
running
money come
their
from?
Communities.
We're going to shut the money down. Look. Purdue Pharmaceutical.
No, you don't have to shut it down.
Bankrupted.
You got to make sure
things
fit right.
Listen,
like Elijah Cummings
Purdue,
blowing.
Purdue Pharmaceutical filing bankruptcy is a beginning. You got to bankrupt all these pharmaceutical companies. You got to bankrupt a lot of these types of industries.
But so much of
the
stuff we talk about as far as
why
are these pharmaceutical companies giving these kids dope so early in their life? Because they're. You know, they're telling parents who are uninformed anyway, these communities need to be informed with community gardens, organic gardens, you know what I mean? And educate, it starts with home, dude. People, it has to get start. People need to seriously start getting educated and organized
on a grassroots level.
You can't ask an Elijah Cummings, you can't ask an Elijah Cummings who's a black dude, who's been in Baltimore for fucking 30 years, when he's given $3 trillion, the conditions in that fucking city don't change. We need to stop. Politicians are politicians, whether they're black or white. That's another thing they said. You can't be fucking with people who are part of this broke system, dude. You need real, real people who want real change on a grassroots level. Because at the end of the day, dude, you say it all the time, a tax revolt. The only thing they fuck with and they listen to is economics. If you pull your economics back or at the voting booth, vote these motherfuckers out or don't spend any money on the shit they support. Period. The end. But at the end of the day, it starts with education. You'll keep spending your money on dumb shit unless you know what not to spend your money on.
Right. Well, and I go back to the pharmaceuticals, you know, the pharmaceutical companies spend up to as close to what? $7 billion a year on network advertising. Networks don't survive without that money. But if we bankrupt them, look, eventually they've got a different master. And if we go after that master, they have no master. And they look, We know the media isn't telling us the truth. We know that, okay? Anybody that believes media is telling the truth, God help your soul. God help you. But, you know, it's got to come down to factual. You know, I was on the news yesterday. I did a self-defense seminar, a women's self-defense seminar. And I just said, listen, self-defense is for everybody. We've got a generation of children being raised on pharmaceutical drugs. We have 40 million Americans, adults that are on psychotropic drugs. They're zombies. They're literally zombies. And I think it's for a reason. One, money. Two, malleable people who will just believe what the box on the wall tells them, right? And look, if you're not questioning, if you're not sitting back and at least questioning what the media is telling you, I can't believe there are people out there who don't question the narrative, who don't say,
Hold on. Yeah.
Why would Iran want to get blown into fucking oblivion? Why would they want that? Unless they're being paid billions of dollars, which they were by the last administration, pallets of it. There's pictures of the money on the jets being taken to the Ayatollahs and the Iranian generals and everybody else. That money got dispersed, and now they are the puppets of the people that paid them, correct?
Absolutely.
So
that's the same thing that happened in the 80s.
Let's go ahead and have a slow upgrade, a slow uptick in this confrontation. We're going to go ahead and start with hitting pipelines. Then we're going to blow a few holes in some tankers. Then we're going to go ahead and kidnap some tankers. Then we're going to grab some Americans and imprison them for 10 years, which CBS and ABC and NBC are reporting on, of course. And then we're going to have drones go up, which does Iran have drones good enough to go up with missiles to hit refineries?
Of course they do.
You think they do?
Of course they do, but they didn't do it. Like I said, it's just so counterintuitive to them. Like, why? You just don't, whatever.
Iran hasn't started a war in how many hundreds of years?
Right, that's what I'm saying. But we have. We've started several. But yet we believe them every time when they tell us who started the
Several is a pretty light order, right?
Fuck ass light. They're pushing over babies in incubators, and they're killing them, and their babies are falling on the floor. The little fucking bitch who said that was the Kuwaiti ambassador's daughter, who that shit ran throughout the world, drumming up support for the war for the Operation Desert Storm. They lied to us all the freaking time. But Lee Stranahan, they said it today, and we say it all the time. It's only through historical perspective. Like, oh, yeah, Gulf of Tonkin was horseshit 20, 10, 15, 20 years later.
And here's the thing. You know, here's the thing. Last night I stopped and spent time with some Special Forces veterans, a bunch of great guys, man. And I support the military. I support all the soldiers, the sailors, the airmen, everybody. I love being around them. Because they signed their name on the dotted line and they did what they were told. I had several of them who listened to our show who go, man, you guys are so spot on. You're so over the target with everything you're saying. And a lot of them realize it kind of after the fact and what they've been through. And it's horrible what's going on, these wars to put Americans through and destroy nations and everything else we're doing. And I said to them, I go, I get it. I spend $2.40 on gas. What are they spending on it in England? What are they spending on it in France? They're spending like $7 a gallon, you know, $8 a gallon for gas because they're being enslaved. They're paying the carbon taxes, number one. They're biting into the climate change hoax that's going on. If the climate's changing, we're not doing it, okay? We're not doing it. It is the sun.
Giant
ball in the sky.
See, like we talked about, who did we talk about? James Corbett. You're absolutely right. I think these changes are more what could really affect the weather. But we are now fucking with shit. We are now terraforming.
Oh, yeah.
So even though it's not man-made climate change as far as industrial shit, that's not what I'm talking about. The man-made climate change I'm believing in now is the shit we're doing to fuck with the atmosphere that is changing the weather. Well, we've been able to control the weather since the late 30s, early 40s.
Right? Gates admitted that we're spraying in the Southwest. You know, he admitted to it.
It's a part of public record. Go back to our climate change episode, whether it was Jim Lee in the weather modification one or the one with Corbett. Like it's right there in front of your face, dude. It's government records to show it exists.
Yeah,
weather modification absolutely exists.
Colin Cantrell, I love you too, buddy.
Long story short, dude, there's a lot going on, man. There was a lot going on, and what they're feeding is just, like, Epstein's even gone out of the news, but what they were telling us about this guy.
How is that? Is another part. How is that?
That's what drives me so aggro, dude.
Here's what's hilarious. They're accusing Judge Kavanaugh of some sort of other sexual assault. When then they had to correct, the New York Times had to correct their article and say the woman who was the accuser,
she didn't even remember it.
She didn't even remember the encounter. It's insane. And at the same time, they're saying they want to impeach Kavanaugh for a sexual encounter while Epstein's gone out of the news. And he's got 1,000 accomplices who were raping children on his island and in his New York mansion. This is the insanity that we're dealing with right now. This is the news telling us what we should
do. Listen to me. The crux of all of this, and you know it, you're just afraid to say it, and I'm fucking ashamed of you, dude. Antonio Brown going to the Patriots is some bullshit.
Yeah, because we need to make that big news. And then accuse him of sexual assault.
Yes, you know what I'm saying? This is the real fucking story. This is the linchpin of it all.
Look, I don't want to be the alternate news, the news story that takes over for Epstein. You don't want to be that guy. Stay out of the news cycle until that shit's done with.
But that's what they do, though. That's exactly what they just feed us a bunch of fucking nonsense. And then, I was reading today about some of the different legislation that went through. I have to go through my notes. That was passing during the shootings that were happening. It's just all of this, dude. All of this is fucking nuts, dude. And it's run by the eugenicists, and they are moving towards a technocracy where data will be the new oil. They're monitoring and listening to everything the fuck you do. And if Trump is a white hat, Why is the Patriot Act still on the books? Why is NDAA 1 and 2 on the books, which allows for your potential assassination if you're deemed
a threat?
Well,
look, here's the thing. Here's the thing that I'll point out to any liberals that are listening. At the current time, most Republicans or right-leaning individuals believe that the NDAA and Patriot Act benefits us because he's going after political opponents.
Man, which that's horseshit.
He may or may not be. But here's what I'm saying. Someone's going to come along who goes like the other
pimp.
Way.
That's like a pimp who's like, I beat you because I love you.
What I'm saying is that we don't want anyone to have that power in government because they're going to abuse one side or the other or all of us eventually. So it needs to be shut down.
But it hasn't been. And it's been there for now going on 20 years.
I know that. This is what's opened the door for all of this surveillance. It needs to be shut down. That the NDAA needs to be removed. The Patriot Act needs to be removed. And we need to be given back our freedom, is what I'm saying.
But we don't hear about that.
Here's what it's going to come down to. Here's what it's going to come down to. I'm going to have to write you a letter on Monday so that you get it on Friday so that you're ready for the rundown on the next Monday for the show that we're doing and the material we're doing. I can't write you emails anymore. I can't send you Facebook messages.
Right.
I can't send you messages on Twitter because they're monitoring.
Wouldn't that be awesome?
We're going to have to do snail mail. We're all going to have to go back to snail mail. Look, if I want to start a revolution in the United States, I'm going to have to buy 17 million stamps and then send 17 million letters through snail mail to everyone that I want to join me in some sort of civil uprising.
Hey, got to Paul Revere that shit, dude. How'd they do it back in the day? The Revolutionary War happened. How'd they let that word spread?
The socialists are coming.
The globalists are coming, dude.
Well, globalists are socialists.
It goes right left, dude. There is in this tree, this flow chart of all these people Epstein's been involved with, through all of these money launderings and all these schemes going on throughout the world, there's plenty of Republicans in there too, dude.
Well, yeah, he's compromising everybody. It was compromising everybody.
I would dare to venture
that many of the people who are now globalists are because they're compromised, not because they want to be globalists.
No, for sure. No, absolutely not. That's how they get themselves fucked. Like, ah, damn, I'm all neck deep in this shit. Now I can't get out. But at the end of the day, the dark work is being done. And we have to start, like I've said before, man, whatever the problem, we're talking about the shootings. Everybody's like, fucking pharmaceuticals, blah, 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 blah. I get it. But what if this was one of these concocted shootings by the feds? What if this is one of these wind-up motherfuckers? Gladio style.
Well, I saw the video. I mean, I posted
I understand,
video
but if we can't,
of the guy
if we
that
don't.
Was,
if,
that was hypnotized into doing a shooting. He was
if
hypnotized.
If we don't look at that as a possibility shooting. Without thinking you're crazy or whatever, if you don't, you know what I mean? We have several options in a shooting. It was legit, you know, he's got all these problems, or it was some manufactured crazy shit. If we don't get that things like Gladio existed, movie theaters, schools, grocery stores, at the end of World War II and leading up to the end of the Cold War to demonize communism, this is real shit. Again, don't mind killing people to fulfill their larger political agenda.
Right. So in the end, just enlighten yourself, folks. Do research. I'm going to go back and hang out with my wife.
There you go.
I think this was a great conversation, but we love you all. And thank you very much for joining us. And tomorrow, Dr. Jerome Corsi will be joining us at noon.
Absolutely.
We'll air it later in the day. And I think you'll get a bit of an education from the doctor and our interaction.
And if you leave with anything, I think I said this earlier, but I do want to reiterate it. The software which is going into all of this different tech around us, whether it's government databases or our phones, is the backbone of an infrastructure that has an incoming technocracy that has back doors which allows for massive surveillance of U.S. civilians, not just the legal stuff to the U.S. It's deep, man. It's deep.
Right.
Look up how deep it goes if you can.
MK Ultra, Operation Gladio, Gladio 2. Look it all up, folks.
Oh, man. And it's even deeper. Palantir. Look up Palantir
software.
Look up Peter Thiel. He was a part of your boy's transition team, dude. Peter Thiel developed this software that's been
helpful
for the Constitution, et cetera, et cetera. All right, boy. Love you. And happy anniversary, man. Tell Lynn I said thank you for letting us borrow you for a hot minute. You guys are great for hanging out with us. Peace, man.
Thanks for hanging out, everybody.
Ah. Holla.